Blackstone Audiobooks presents Time's Fool by Leonard Tourney. Read by Tony J. First, the author of Time's Fool, Leonard Tourney.
Acknowledgements. We know too little of Shakespeare's life and even less of his personality and character. All the better for the novelist whose imagination needs time unaccounted for and a certain expanse of blank canvas. Therefore, with the details of Shakespeare's life during the years in which the story takes place, I have taken those little liberties, call it poetic license if you will, that have become conventional in novels whose grist is names, dates, and works of actual persons. In so doing, I point to the worthy example of Shakespeare himself, who presented not a few historical characters on his stage, filled their mouths with words they never uttered, and invested those characters with personalities that may have been quite different from those they actually possessed. To readers offended by such practices, I offer this poor palliative. History, too, is a work of the imagination. For helping bring this book about in ways large and small, my thanks to the following. To the Davidson Library of the University of California at Santa Barbara and its staff for a ready supply of books, articles, and documents on England's greatest playwright in his time. To my agent, Elizabeth Winnick, at McIntosh & Otis Incorporated, for her faith and extraordinary diligence. To my quick-eyed copy editor, India Cooper, who saved me from a multitude of literary sins of commission and omission. To my daughter, Anne Tourney, for invaluable technical help in preparation of the manuscript. To my editor, Bob Gleason, who, after viewing an earlier version of this book, first suggested that Will Shakespeare be permitted to speak for himself. Finally, to my wife, Judith O'Lawson, actress and director, whose production of Measure for Measure inspired certain elements of the novel's plot and whose patience and encouragement are pearls beyond price.
To whoever finds this book. Love is bitter, and love is sweet, but more bitter than sweet, and a nearer cousin to grief than to pleasure. These are my very words. I wrote them once years ago in a play never performed, never even finished. I should have carved them on my heart. Sour grapes, think you? Truth, rather, friend. The voice of experience, which does speak more loudly than Seneca or Socrates or whatever other cobwebbed philosopher please you. Ask the man and not the mantle. By Mary's blessed son, he'll tell you the same. But I write not of generals, rather of particulars. Which brings me to this book, a book I write as much for penance's sake as for monument to her whom I once loved and whose death I caused. Not because I murdered her, but because I bred, without intention, madness and treachery and, yes, murder too. A conundrum, you say? A mystery? Well, so it was. A mystery to me, as well as to others. My penance is this memoir. Nothing extenuating, nothing concealed, every jot and tittle of the broken law laid bare before your eyes, that you may judge how I did acquit myself, for what reasons, and in what peril to myself and to my friends. Therefore, friend, when you find these yellowed papers in time to come, secreted behind plastered wall or buried deep in well or cave, pray do not cast them off or use these mortal pages to feed some ravenous fire. I promise you they will not warm, but chill the blood with something novel, something strange. My repentance will not serve me unless I confess at least to one other soul. Talk not to me of confessor.
Thank you. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.